You want to know why medical marijuana helps with your arthritis? In today's video, we're going to explain why. So when I'm with a patient, I often find myself in a discussion about why medical cannabis or medical marijuana will actually help or might help with their arthritis. Blake, can you walk us through a little bit of arthritis and cannabinoids and why this, like a little bit more in-depth discussion about how I'm going to talk to my patient about this?
Yes. So let's get to the big issue first about arthritis in general. So when we think about arthritis or cells in general, right? This is a phospholipid bilayer. This is what all cell membranes are made out of. And then you have transmembrane bound proteins that extend both internally and externally to the cell. And typically on one of these transmembrane bound proteins, you have like an antenna almost. It's a little recognition protein that when you have an immune cell comes by, it also has a little protein on it. This one says, "Hi, I'm Tim." And this one over here says, "I'm also Tim." And when they communicate together, there's no problem. Now, what ends up happening is, and we regenerate our cells and so forth, but when you talk about arthritis, especially in the joints, your joints often do not repair themselves. And so you end up cleaving off this part. And so you've broken the antenna essentially. And so when an immune cell comes by or a self-recognition cell comes by, it will say, "I'm Tim," and then there's static here. There's nothing. What this does is it sets a cascade response where basically you're now going to send a whole bunch of immune functions to go destroy whatever this is that's not Tim.
This is why my knee gets inflamed.
This is why your knee gets inflamed, because you're having an immune response against your own cells because you're no longer recognizing your cells as your own. And so your body has a typical response. It's the same thing when you have pollen or have an actual allergic reaction. It is a foreign body that your body doesn't recognize. And in the case of pollen, it's if you're allergic to pollen, right? For some people, they can sniff pollen all day, but the idea is still the same. When your body encounters it, if it can't recognize what it is, it attacks it.
I can't wait to ask. Do you have a cannabinoid or a cannabis product that can help me?
Yes. So when we think about how cannabis actually helps this process, part of the immune response is to cause inflammation. And that inflammation is a direct result of histamines. You're sending more blood to the area. You're sending your armies in to defeat the foreign invader. So you're just, inflammation goes up. And especially when you're around a joint, you can inflame so much that you can actually lock the joint so it's no longer mobile. And so if we can take that whole process down a little bit and we can say, "Hey, we're not dying. My joint is just fine. Everyone relax," and you can lower that inflammation a little bit, all of a sudden, you're not having the same types of issues. And so how do we do that? CBG seems to have the ability, and it's because of how it permeates the cell membrane. And we can talk just real briefly about that. But basically, when you calculate how molecules move across a membrane, we're talking about Q log P values. The higher the Q log P, the more permeable it is to go across a membrane, right? And so different cannabinoids have higher or lower Q log P. So when we say THC absorbs better in the cellular endocannabinoid receptor 2 system than endo 1. Why is that? Other than CBD, it's because THC is about 5.8, okay? Whereas CBD is at about 5.2. And so when you look at these different types of Q log P values, the permeability, what ends up happening is what we found with CBG is CBG absorbs across this membrane in a similar location of where you hold peroxisomes, which are often used to create histamines when your body has a histamine response. And so by down-regulating that heightened response and down-regulating production, you lower inflammation.
So I use a little THC, like we talked about, for the disassociation so I can continue the activity. And then I add CBG so that I can reduce the inflammation and the histamine response with my patients. I think that's a pretty good discussion. watch for another video when we talk to, when we have this same discussion with a pharmacist and we talk about the products and how they kind of choose which products to recommend when they're right in the pharmacies.
That's right. And this is also, by the way, the reason why balms and topicals work so well is because you're applying it directly to the area. And I don't have to get all the way down to the bloodstream to go hit the liver and then come back with a metabolite that is actually going to serve a function. I just need to literally get down to the nerve cell and then we're good to go. So it's really an effective way to think about this.